Hey y'all, this is your K-pop auntie Carly, and I am back with another AT's reaction. We have Better today. I'm working on their last album here. Looks like I'm pr gonna have time to get all the way through their discography before a comeback. I'm sure they're planning a comeback out fairly soon here. I haven't announced anything that I know of, but I think they've been dropping hints, haven't they? I think. Anyways. Very cool. Working through the last of the album, and then I am going to start getting to all sorts of different requests that you guys have as far as live performances, award shows, all that good stuff. Some of it's gonna have to go up on Patreon because once you start getting more and more into live performances and award shows, the more and more likely that stuff's gonna be blocked. So check out that link down there. That is the free page for my Patreon, so you can get a good idea of what's inside, as well as just a ton of stuff that's gonna continue to be free. But stuff does disappear off of that free page and go inside the paywall as well. So that's how it is. All right. We have a live stage performance here, and then I'm going to get into the lyrics version. An all-white concept. Turn it up more. Ooh, that. Right. Okay, so before they, I feel like they're building here. So before they build, first impressions, okay. Definitely not in my like immediate slower song I like it list, but it's kind of growing on me, especially when you throw Mingi in there with that raspy has him in his voice. I'm like, okay, he got me a little bit, kind of the piano and everything. I like the classical instruments being used in slower songs, so I'm kind of like this. We'll see. I do kind of like this beat that they have because there's like that real simple piano key hitting in the background, and you have the snares hitting up front, and kind of a. I need to get more musical vocabulary going on, but a bit of a trap feel. I don't know, maybe with the not trap. What am I saying? You hear the. Mic does he have? Nice. Nice dance step, and I like that. I like the chorus. Yeah.
Better,
That is like a total feature in AT's discography and stage performances. I know it's for a variety of reasons. It just makes me smile every time that you have AT's like dancing away and Jungho just struts the catwalk like a model coming down the center. This happens so much. I love it. Here I come. Get it, buddy. Yep, sudden stop. Very cool. Yeah, that was one of the ones that's kind of a little bit in my middle ground as far as like the musical style that I enjoy. So, what would you say it's in my middle ground? I don't dislike it. It's not like I would, like, pass that one by at all, but I'm not sure I'd playlist it. And that's, like, AT's has been really hitting lately on my list of good, like, songs continually that I like. So it's much less often that I'm coming across songs in their albums that I'm like, I probably wouldn't playlist it, but there are definitely elements in the song that I like. Like I said, I like the songs that have kind of the classical elements in them if they're going to be slower. Heck, I like songs that are faster that have classical elements in them. But I do want to get into the lyrics because usually second time around listening to the lyrics, it does make stuff grow on me once I get into the meaning of everything. And from the English that's in the song, it seems like kind of a like optimistic looking forward type of song that, you know, things are getting better, we're getting better, things are progressing and it's gonna be okay kind of song. Better, you know, things are getting better. So yeah, let's see what the rest of it has to say. Crushed by rushing anxiety, I sometimes feel like a burned tree. Interesting, like a burned tree. That's quite the, you don't hear that expression a lot, but yeah, a burned tree would be, well, it depends on how bad the fire was, but a burned tree can look completely dead from the outside once a forest fire goes past, but being charred and burned on the outside, there's still the core is still alive and kind of has to come out. And you'll see, like, after one of the actual beautiful things about the tragedy of a forest fire is the next spring is just a massive popping of green because, like, there's a ton of underbrush burned away, all the dead limbs and stuff are burned away, and this gorgeous resurgence of green comes. And it's like, yeah, so that's immediately what was brought to my mind by sometimes I feel like a burned tree is sometimes I feel like this crushing and rushing anxiety. Well, this crushing anxiety is like a rushing wildfire that is burned at me and it looks like I'm dead, but inside is still that green wood, you know, waiting for just a burst forward again. Keep falling down. Oh, you're back. I feel trapped again. Is growing up always like this? Please tell me I'm doing fine. I guess it's not always like that, but a lot of it is like that. I don't think there are many people that have grown up without at least moments of, like, extreme anxiety and feeling like you're caught in a forest fire and not knowing what to do with yourself. I mean, we all have those moments, even if, like, it's not, though, like, your entire youth feels like that. We all have had, yeah, those moments where it's just overwhelming. I want to grow up and I want to go forward. I haven't really heard them tackling growing up themes much, so this is interesting. To the place I've been dreaming of, far away. Even though I walk slow, I hope I don't get lost tonight. Relying on each other, like that. Hey, take my hand, because I have you who are the same as me. We know we're getting better. Don't worry, nothing matter. Yeah, I do like, it is kind of that kind of song, isn't it? It's a song about, okay, growing up, having each other as a group, probably having a teeny, and they're in that point in their lives. I mean, it's Yuno's birthday today, as of my recording this. He is 24, he's a young man, and I was dating my husband by the time I was 24, but I don't really call it dating. Whatever we were doing when we were 24. Don't get me started. But now I'm really distracted. Growing up. It is definitely a big growing up time. And, yeah, don't worry. Nothing matters. It's just saying, hey, it's still an extremely formative time of your life, and they have each other again. They have A-teeny getting better, and I know, before the distraction, they're also in a very transformative time in their career. They're still pretty young and hitting the hurdles and everything, and especially with the big wrench the pandemic threw into everybody's wheel spokes that just made this huge stutter step happen in everybody's career. So getting better. It's fine, even if you fall, don't stop. That's all you need to do. We can get lost a bit more. I'm different from yesterday's me. Nice. I like that. Different from yesterday's me. I want to feeling my life. I'd like to winning my life. That was in English. That was an interesting sentence structure for English. Sorry, book editor just said sentence structure, but I gotta try to figure out why he's saying it like that. Because that's time. I'm sorry, I'm just having a hard time with, I want to feeling my life. I'd like to winning my time. I guess it's kind of like, I want to feeling, they did that on purpose. It's not like they don't know English. They know English, they know sentence structure, they put it in the song. I want to feeling my life. I'd like to winning my time. There's, hi, how are you? This is Doc. Doc is happy. There's a reason they did that. So I'm guessing they're taking the phrase feeling my life and they're saying, I want to do that. Feeling my life. I want to do that. Winning my time. I'd like to do that. You know, kind of chopping it up like that. Thank you for walking in front of the camera. Yeah, just taking the concept of feeling my life as opposed to being numb, I guess. Like, I want to do that. I want to feeling my life. The concept of winning my time. Like, I'd like to do that. I'm guessing that's why they kind of chopped it up like that a little bit. I hope all the moments I've dreamed of shines. I hope it will be shining. Will be shining. Tears in diamond. Trap the tears. Shining for a moment, the twist behind it does hurt, but we know each other. Okay, we got shining stuff going. I hope all the moments I've dreamed of shines. So we have shinings and diamonds. I'm rewinding. Hold on. I hope it will be shining. Will be shining. So all the moments I've dreamed of. So the it they're talking to about is the moments they've dreamed of. I hope those moments will be shining. Tears and diamond. Trap the tears. Okay, so I don't know if Tears in Diamond. Again, that's in English. They're definitely playing with English in a interesting way. Tears in Diamond. Trap the Tears. Does he say actually Tears in Diamond? I'm sorry. Yeah, Tears and Diamonds. I think there's an S on the end of there. Tears and Diamonds. Trap the Tears. So that's like tears inside of diamonds. Okay, because diamonds are formed off of a very, very long time of extremely hard pressure. So tears encased inside of diamonds. That's kind of what that makes me automatically think of is, diamonds being formed because of the extremely tight pressure put on, is it coal? Is it coal that actually, like, over centuries, diamonds are made out of? But yeah, tears inside of that pressure cooker, Trap those tears, shining for a moment, the twist behind it. It does hurt, but we know each other. All right, so back to the shining for a moment. And again, the shining is. It could be the tears. It could be the goals that he was talking about. Twist, it does hurt. The twisting hurts, but we know each other. I know I'm with you. Lean on. That's like us to a brighter tomorrow. Leaning on each other to the place I've been dreaming of. Even though I walk slow, I hope I don't get lost tonight. Relying on each other. He's over there just purring. Just purring. Fine, even if you fall, don't stop. I'll have to keep an eye on how they play with English because they're twisting it. And like I said, it's not like they don't know how to speak English. They obviously know. Like the differences in the grammar there is on purpose. Like that's they're not making grammatical mistakes or like it's on purpose that they're doing that. So I'm going to keep an eye on that. I'm interested on how they kind of take and twist phrases and create images like that. Don't worry what you do, bring our hands together. And promise when we're together, we're getting better. And I like this whole concept that they have here of, hey, we're getting better, man. We're getting better. And I agree, they are. I like their albums more and more as the my little journey through their discography has gone. They sound like they're getting their sound. And that doesn't mean that it's like one specific sound that they have. It's not like they're being repetitive in the least. Because, I mean, like with Stray Kids, they just dropped their new album and it's full of all these different sounds. And it's still, you're like, oh, that's so Stray Kids. So even though it's so different, it's very much them. I feel like 80s is starting to kind of get that a little bit where their songs have that kind of 80s thing to them, So looking forward to more. And yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing how they play with English a little bit in there to kind of use wordplay in everything because English is the international language. Say what you will about the quote unquote dominance of English. Well, we've always had international languages. It used to be French. And actually, not all that long ago, it used to be French, just to work as a language in which other people from other languages are able to talk to each other. And I'm actually seeing that a lot watching BTS content over on, Patreon, is that, they're able to travel to other countries that don't speak English as their primary language and use it as a the second and third language that they're able to communicate with other people with. And ATEEZ is a very international group right now, and they kind of know that by throwing English into these songs that it's going to be that kind of international language that helps them communicate with a bunch of different ATEEZ fans all across different different countries and boundaries. So it'll be interesting to see how much they play with the language and kind of twist it around a little bit and use phrases and stuff. All right, that is it for me. That is it for me. I have to get back to work. My day is proceeding along, and I need to finish my editing job today. Making good progress. So, you all have yourselves a wonderful day.